Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to work on this Epson ET-2750. To show the problem, I have to turn the back of the printer. The problem is that paper feeding. The printer starts okay, but if you send a page to print, you're going to get this. And then it's going to stop. Paper out in rear paper feed, confirm the size and low paper. If you look carefully about the gear, and you're going to see the gear is actually broken into two right here. This gear is called a shaft LD. So we go to bchtechnologies.com and we just type in LD and do a search. And there are two parts important. One is this four-piece holder clutch, and those gears controls if the shaft LD is going to rotate or not. And the shaft LD is the broken part. I mentioned the holder clutch is because sometimes the LD is not turning, and you're going to fix the holder clutch. But however, for this one, we know is the LD is turning, it just broken into half. And here's the part that's broken. Here's a working printer. I'm turning the holder clutch, and you can see the shaft LD is turning and is pushing the paper tray in the back. It's called hopper. It's pushing the hopper plate in the back. For comparison, here's the broken printer. When we turn the wheel on the holder clutch, and you can see this part is broken. So when I turn it, it cannot push the hopper towards back. Usually you get a spring in the back of the hopper, and that's the reason actually you break this. So you have to make sure that your hopper can be pushed back. For this video, I'm going to show you how to replace the shaft LD. We're going to remove the paper stacker. There are two tabs, one on each side, and just push them in and lift it up. It's going to be removed. Since we're here, we're going to remove three screws, two on the left, one on the right. Then we're going to turn the printer towards the back, and we're going to remove this cover for the waste tank. Oh, by the way, the piece come out with a screw. You cannot totally unscrew. Then one more screw underneath the waste tank, and you can remove the waste tank. Then we remove that paper protector. Just put your hand in the middle and lift it. And remove one screw, and then this box can be lifted straight up. Then three screws on the left and two screws on the right. And now you can remove this top plate. And we're going to remove the right-hand panel. This panel has three tabs. One tab is right here in the middle, and so you're pushing from the from below, and there are two tabs on the back of the plate. So we're going to, it's out of focus, but you're going to push in and push that tab in. It's okay, lots of people broke that tab, that's fine. We're going to remove the duplexer before we push in and work on the final two tabs. Now we're going to remove this panel. There's a screw underneath here. Okay, let me actually just lift it up and show you. See the whole bunch of screws? Select the top one and unscrew this. On the scanner, we're going to remove the two screws on the scanner hinge. So now the scanner is going to be released. So you'll probably want to have a box or have somebody hold it for you. And push the panel to your left, it's going to fall out. And then now there are two FFC cable from the scanner, a double-sided tape on the printer. So just remove the tape and take the printer out. Now we're going to remove this unit called a paper set detection unit. If you need it, just go to bchtechnologies.com and search for it. So there are two screws. If you don't have angled screwdriver, you have to remove the front panel. Two screws on the left, and this ink cover can just directly removed. And two on the right, and there will be two screws, one on each side, inside the printer, and you get those two removed. And there are two screws in front of the ink tank. Yeah, all you're trying to do is actually just open up the front panel so you can put your screwdriver through it. And remove one screw right here. And now you're free to remove the one screw on the bottom and one screw on the top. If you have angled screwdriver and you don't have to remove the front panel. See that dot? Just push it in and slide the casing towards your left. And this PSD unit is going to come off. And the PSD unit is hosting the chef LD. So now we're going to remove the chef LD. You're going to see the two tabs. Push a tab in and just draw the LD towards your left, and the whole thing can be removed. And now we can get the new one in and just enjoy printing. Just in case you mess up this holder clutch, you got four pieces. And the first piece, you can hold it like this. Then we'll add a second piece and have this long arm forcing forward. And you can see there are two small hooks. That'll be the place for the spring. So now we add this really big piece and then we just need to install the spring.
Hello, mortals. Your printer is saved. Kevin's YouTube channel is the answer to your prayers.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.